Today, we will be discussing the poem London by William Blake. William Blake was born in London, England on November 28, 1757 and died August 12, 1827. He is considered an early Romantic era poet. Common themes that surround some Romantic era poetry include importance of emotion and imagination, fever for the innocence of childhood, and an interest and concern for the society of outcasts. Blake viewed the French Revolution as a glorious new beginning that would end tyranny and absolute power. Blake was considered a visionary. He did not conform to the thoughts of others. He valued imagination over reason and pushed for change in his hometown of London, England. As the revolution turned into a mess of bloodshed and mass executions, Blake wrote simple and direct poems to those of his own generation about how individuals were directly affected by the revolution that lived in London. The poem London was published in 1794 in a book of poems titled Songs of Innocence and Experience, showing the two contrary states of the human soul. I will now read London by William Blake. I wander through each chartered street, near where the chartered Thames does flow, and mark in every face I meet, marks of weakness, marks of woe. In every cry of every man, in every infant's cry of fear, in every voice, in every ban, the mind-forged manacles I hear. How the chimney sweepers cry, every blackening church appalls, and the hapless soldier's sigh runs in blood down palace walls. But most through midnight streets I hear how the youthful harlot's curse blasts the newborn infant's tear and blights with plagues the marriage hearse. The poem is written in iambic pentameter and follows the beat da-dum. For example, for where the chartered Thames does flow. Tetrameter is a verse of four measures, therefore each stanza has eight beats. However, there is a point in the poem where Blake does make a shift from eight beats to seven. And marks in every face I meet, marks of weakness, marks of woe. This change in beats portrays the speaker's surprise at the weakness and woe that consumes the city and is all around him. The line itself is plagued with weakness, having one less syllable than it should, signifying it is sick, imperfect, and broken, just like the people that the speaker encounters. Word choice is also incredibly important in Blake's poem. Words such as chartered, manacles, and ban are used throughout the poem and signify the major themes that Blake addresses. Social life is constricted, confined, and repressed. The regulated rhythm and rhyme scheme and structure reflects ideas of entrapment and constraint as well. Blake uses sound to bring the city to life and uses onomatopoeia to give the reader a better understanding of the thoughts and emotions that the speaker is feeling while walking around London. But most through midnight streets I hear how the youthful harlot's curse blasts the newborn infant's tear and blights with plagues the marriage hearse. The speaker hears cries throughout the city and uses specific words to signify the strength and significance those cries carry. The words blast itself makes the reader hear the sound of an actual blast, and having it placed at the beginning of the line creates the effect of the stanza blasting our senses and blasting away the newborn innocence. This stanza that closes out the poem makes a strong statement about death and marriage. The harlot's curse ruins and destroys marriages by blighting it with plagues both metaphorically and literally, stating marriage is most definitely dead. Symbolism is a very important aspect to the poem London as well. Blake chooses carefully what to discuss and how to address those issues. How the chimney sweepers cry, every blackening church appalls, and the hapless soldier's sigh runs in blood down palace walls. This is a very powerful stanza. Blake is directly addressing the root of the problem that the city is facing. The chimney sweepers symbolize the exploitation of children, as they were often the ones that held that job. Their cries either making the church look shameful for allowing that to happen or making the church sympathize with them. The speaker is uncertain about how to feel regarding the church's role in the cries that fill the streets. However, the blackening of the church shows the institution as becoming less good and devoted to helping those in need. The sigh that the soldiers let out and runs down the palace walls is a metaphor accusing the government of forcing the helpless soldiers to carry out the dirty work of the government and have the blood on their hands. As we follow the speaker throughout the city, he expresses his feelings that powerful institutions, such as the church and monarchy, are causing London to fall. London is a very dark and sneaky poem. In this poem, the speaker, who is never addressed but is assumed to be Blake himself, focuses on the inescapable poverty and misery that covers the city of London. The poem focuses on the social downfalls of the city, which includes orphans, the poor and homeless, hygiene, and death and disease. The Industrial Revolution was taking place at this time, and people were coming in vast numbers from the country to find a new way of life in the city of London. London became overcrowded. The Thames River, once where the city got their drinking water, was now diluted and toxic due to the sewage and garbage that was dumped into the river. This led to disease and death among those that called the streets their home, as homelessness was at an all-time high. The smell of the city was ripe. The ground was damp due to the river, and those that had the luxury of using a chamber pot to go to the restroom would empty the contents onto the streets. The open holes in the cemeteries that housed 20 dead bodies filled the air with rotting corpses. One out of every two children would die before the age of two during this time. The sights and sounds that fill London suggest that what the speaker sees and hears around him is cyclical and repetitive. The evil that London is under will continue to persist. At that time, London was a dark and hopeless place.